It's 2:58, sir. And it's starting 3 o'clock, sir. Sir.
So, this is your
sir.
Today's experiment is your scattering characteristics of circulator. If you are seeing, this is your microwave test pen. Here you are having the reflex crystal, you are having the isolator, variable attenuator is here, diaphragmatic frequency meter, slotted line, and finally here you are having the circulator. This is the circulator. Okay. So from your reflex crystal, sub signal is transmitted, sub signal is coming. Here you are having two different ports are there. Okay. So when we are giving the input, here you are having the klystron power supply. In klystron power supply, you will have some beam voltage. So let us assume that here you are having say 250 volts, that is your beam voltage. And we go for repeller voltage. Repeller voltage means we will adjust the repeller voltage so as to get the waveform in the CRO. The place where you are getting the waveform, there we have to stop. And repeller voltage is there, you are getting the waveform. Okay, so here we will stop. Okay, now we are, so we will make one tabular column.
Okay,
we are keeping input at port 1. This is your port 1, we are keeping input here. Okay, we are taking output from your port 2. Okay, and you are having port 3. This is your port 3. So the characteristics of the circulator is, when you are getting input at port 1, you will get output at port 2 and you will not get anything at port 3. Okay, that is the characteristics of your circulator. Okay, so here we will measure that what is the output that you are getting it. So when we are going for finding your port 2, here you are having something. We will see what is the amplitude of it. Amplitude, or you can say it as the height. Say here, what is your volt per division? Number of divisions?
Increasing.
Number of division? Can we say 1.5? Okay. So 3.0 millivolt. 3.0. It is coming the millivolt that you are getting at your port 2 by V2. Okay, and we have to calculate the isolation. Isolation will be 20 log 10 V1 by V3. Okay, so this you got the value of your P2. Now we will replace this with this one, and this termination will connect it here so that we can see the output from your port 3. Okay, and we'll note down the value of your port 3. And we will remove this and directly will connect it here so that we can see what is your port 1. Okay. So you are having port 1, port 2, port 3. From that you can calculate your coupling coefficient and you can calculate your isolation. Next, we will make say port 2 as in. Then when we are going for the coupling coefficient, we will have port 2 is V2 by V3, that will be your coupling coefficient, and your V2 by V1, that will be your isolation. And similarly, we can go for your port 3 as input. When we are going for port 3 as input, you will have port 1, okay, and here you are having the port 2. So 20 log 10, your V3 by V1, that will be your coupling coefficient. And here you will have V3 by V2, that will be your isolation. So we can calculate all these parameters. So at present we have calculated this. Now we will go for calculating your P3. Okay. We have interchanged your port 2 and port 3. Okay. Input you are having at port 1 and we are seeing output at port 3. Okay. So here, if you are seeing the output, you are getting the waveform in the CRO. Let us see that what is the value that you are getting. Here you are having 50 millivolt. Here you are having 50 millivolt into what about?
It means 1, 2, 3, 4, 4.
How much it is coming? 22.5 millivolt it is coming. Okay, this is the power that you are getting at port 3. Okay, now we will see that what is the power that you are having at port 1. Okay, here. Okay.
in this, we go for measuring the input power, power at port 1. So in order to measure power at port 1, no need for connecting the circulator, directly we'll connect it.
Okay, and here we are seeing that what is your volt per division? What is your volt per division? It is coming.
50.
So, what about the height? 6. So it
the three panel here, height
30
volts. So for what?
300
millivolts. Power at port 2 you are getting 3 millivolts. And power at port 3 you are getting 22.5 millivolts. So just you have to use this formula of your coupling coefficient, that is 20 log 10 V1 means your 300 millivolts by V2, that is your 3 millivolts. So if you solve this one, you will get the coupling coefficient and isolation. Isolation means ideally it should be 0, okay, but here you are getting 20 log 10 V1 is your 300 millivolts and your V3 is coming, it is your 22.5 millivolts. So if you solve this one, here you will get the isolation value. Okay, ideally here you should have the maximum value and here you should have the minimum value. Okay, so here we have put port 1 as input, similarly same you can do for your port 2 and port 3 also. Okay.